When I read about this, I found it almost unbelievable. It's just, really. Merkley said in a phone interview with Time. Are we really putting children through a traumatic experience here in the US in order to dissuade their parents from seeking asylum? On Sunday, the Oregon Democrat attempted to enter a facility in Texas where he says unaccompanied children, including some who were separated from their parents, are being held. Experts say it can be very difficult for the separated family members to reunite. The Trump administration has suggested the policy would be a deterrent for those seeking to come into the U.S. illegally. Going in, Merkley said knew he likely would not be able to access the facility, which is being run by Southwest Key Programs. Prior to the visit, the senator's office had reached out to the federal agency that is responsible for unaccompanied children when they enter the U.S. and told officials that he'd like to see the facility. The senator says his staff was informed that the facility has a policy of not letting people enter, but that if they'd been given extensive advanced warning, they could try to arrange something. There were no guarantees. In a statement to Time, a spokesperson for the Department of Health and Human Services Administration for Children and Families said that the senator and five others attempted to enter the shelter, unannounced and broadcast live via social media last night in Texas, but were thankfully denied entry. According to the ACF website, requests to visit facilities are subject to evaluation before being leased. 2 weeks prior notice is required, though some requests may be granted if there are exigent circumstances. Michelle Brain, the director of the Migrant Rights and Justice Program at the Women's Refugee Commission, says her organization has been monitoring and advocating for oversight of Office of Refugee Resettlement Facilities for a long time. Brain, who has worked on immigration and human rights-related issues for over two decades, says while she thinks there are aspects of the process that need to be improved, visits to OR facilities should be done in a way that is thoughtful and that takes into consideration the protection needs of this population, which can include very young children. Absolutely elected officials, especially those who have a say in how our policies are being implemented, should be able to conduct oversight, but the devil is going to be in the details, she says. There's got to be some process for the facilities and the agencies running the facilities to be able to create the protections necessary for the kids. She adds, the real issue right now is why they are being separated in the first place. She continued, at 2 p.m. on a Friday, the senator asked to visit a secure DHS facility over the weekend where children are present and we worked with him to provide him access. This presented obvious and serious privacy concerns, not to mention disrupting operations. He was able to visit the facility on Sunday. The whole idea of injuring children as a deterrent for those seeking asylum is completely out of character with the soul of America, a nation where the vast bulk of us are from immigrant histories, says Senator Merkley, adding that the U.S. has a responsibility to provide asylum to those who seek it. This is not zero tolerance. It's zero humanity. It's wrong. It must be opposed. It needs to be changed immediately.